In this video, we are going to discuss a few important questions related to Indian polity which have been asked in the past in various different competitive examinations. Let's start with question number 1, as you can see on the screen, which read as follows. Question 1. What among the following is included in the Constitution of India under Part 3? The options are A. Fundamental duties, B. Fundamental rights, C. Guiding principles of state policy, D. Citizenship. The answer to this question is B. Fundamental rights. Part 3 of the Constitution of India talks about fundamental rights. These fundamental rights are given under Article 12 to 35. Article 12 talks about what is state, whereas Article 13 talks about law inconsistent with or in derogation of the fundamental rights. The Article 14 to 32 talks about 6 different kinds of fundamental rights. These are 1. Right to equality, Article 14 to 18 2. Right to freedom, Article 19 to 22 3. Right against exploitation, Article 23 to 24 4. Right to freedom of religion, Article 25 to 28 5. Cultural and educational rights, Article 29 to 30, and finally 6. Right to constitutional remedies, Article 32. The next question is, who was the first speaker of Lok Sabha? The options are A. Hukam Singh, B. Kema Munshi, C. Ganesh V. Mavlinkar, D. UN Debar. The answer from the given options is C. Ganesh V. Mavlinkar. One more important thing to be noted here is that Meera Kumar was the first female chairman of the House of People, that is Lok Sabha. The next question, as you can see on your screen, is that the 9th schedule to the Constitution of India was added by. The options are A. 1st Amendment, B. 8th Amendment, C. 9th Amendment, D. 42nd Amendment. The answer from the given options is A. 1st Amendment. Basically, 9th schedule to the Constitution of India was added by the Constitution, 1st Amendment Act, 1951, and is read with Article 31B of the Constitution of India. Article 31B of the Constitution of India talks about validation of certain acts and regulations. Now let's move on to next question, as you can see on the screen as follows. 73rd Constitutional Amendment is related to which of the following? And the options are A. Panchayat, B. Urban Institutions, C. Cooperative Institutions, D. Grant in Aid Organizations. The answer from the given options is A. Panchayat. This 73th amendment envisages the Gram Sabha as the foundation of the Panchayat Raj system in India to perform functions and powers entrusted to it by the state legislatures. Next question is, Finance Commission is constituted by whom? The options are A. Chief Justice of Supreme Court, B. President, C. Prime Minister, D. Finance Minister. The correct option, B. President. The reason is that the President of India under Article 280 of the Indian Constitution defines the financial relations between the central government of India and the individual state governments. Article 280 is that article which deals with Finance Commission. Question number 6 says, which of the following is relevant about the representation of the Anglo-Indian class in the Lok Sabha? And the options are A. 2 Anglo-Indians to be appointed by the President. B. 1 Anglo-Indian shall be represented. C. The provision to appoint Anglo-Indians has been repealed by the 104th Constitutional Amendment. D. The provision to appoint Anglo-Indians has been repealed by the Presidential Order. Article 331 of the Constitution of India says that the President shall appoint 2 Anglo-Indians if the President is of the opinion that the Anglo-Indians community is not adequately represented. Hence, they are appointed by the President of India. The next question is, what among the following is meant by 0 hour in Lok Sabha? And the options are A. The next says, Articles 330 to 342 of the Constitution of India relate to which of the following? A. State services and administrative tribunals, combined services of union territories. B. Administrative relations between the center and states and union territories in particular. C. Quasi-judicial bodies, Lok Adalats, Gram Adalats. D. Matters relating to scheduled castes and scheduled tribes representation in Lok Sabha and state assemblies. The answer is D. Matters relating to scheduled castes and scheduled tribes representation in Lok Sabha and state assemblies. On this few important article are Article 330 and 332 talks about reservation for scheduled tribe and case in the House of People, that is, Lok Sabha. Article 331 and 333 talks about representation of Anglo-Indians in the House of People, that is, Lok Sabha. Question 9 is how many schedules have been included in the Constitution of India? A. 11, B. 13, C. 12, D. 14. The correct answer is C. 12. These 12 schedules are 1. Schedule 1, the state 2. Schedule 2, provisions related to the president and governor 3. Schedule 3, forms of oath and affirmation 4. Schedule 4, allocation of seats in the Council of State 5. Schedule 5, provisions as to the administration and control of scheduled area and scheduled tribe areas 6. Schedule 6, provisions as to the administration of tribal areas in the state of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram 7. Schedule 7, union list, state list and concurrent list 8. Schedule 8, language 9. Schedule 9, it is related to Article 31B of the Constitution of India 10. Schedule 10, anti-defection law 11. Schedule 11, it is related to Article 234G of the Constitution of India 12. Schedule 12, it is related to Article 243W of the Constitution of India. The last for today is who administers the oath of office to the governor? A. Union Home Minister, B. Chief Justice of High Court of the concerned state, C. The President, D. Prime Minister. The correct answer from the options above is B. Chief Justice of the High Court of the concerned state. These are the few important questions for today. We will deal with other such questions in the upcoming days. To know more about such important questions, subscribe our channel Kashlo.